Welcome to the Video Podcast Speed Challenge. In this video, we're going to use Riverside to go from a completely blank slate computer, nothing open, to a fully published video podcast on YouTube in 20 mouse clicks or less. Yes, we're going to do all of that from recording to having a published video file to getting it on YouTube in less than 20 mouse clicks. Here's how we do it. So two things I did to prepare for this. I sent my guest a link and time to the Riverside studio so they knew when to join and they already had the link. If you do that in the studio, it adds two or three clicks, but you can still do it in the studio. We just tried to do it ahead of time. The other thing is I created an automation using shortcuts on the Mac. Using shortcuts, I can open several URLs in multiple tabs and even multiple web browsers, so everything is ready to record and publish with a single click. If I jump into this shortcut right here, you can see here at the top, I'm gonna open the YouTube channel so it's ready to upload a video, and I'm gonna open that in Safari. I'm gonna open my Riverside Studio to record right here, and that's gonna open in Google Chrome. And I'm going to open another tab in Google Chrome to download the recording all at once. So I don't have to click from the studio to the recordings. I can do it all at once. Now I'm going to trigger that automation from a Stream Deck here on my desk. Technically, it's not a mouse click because it is a shortcut that's on a button right here on the desk. But if we want to count it, I don't want any cheating. We'll say this is click number one, launching the Riverside platforms and YouTube ready for upload, all with an automation. I'll click the button. And you'll see here on the desktop, it actually opens Safari in the background with YouTube ready to upload. It's opened my Riverside Studio, so I'm ready to join. And the recordings tab is also open to the side. Now, you do have to choose whether you're using headphones or not before you enter the studio. You could choose to do this without a mouse. You could actually hit the tab button on your keyboard to I'm using headphones. You might have to go shift tab to go backwards and then hit the space bar to select I'm using headphones. But again, I don't want any cheating here, so I will use a second mouse click to choose I am using headphones. And then our third click is to join the studio. So now here we are in the studio. We're ready for our guest to join us. Don't have to click anything until we're ready to hit record. So Bridget joined the studio at the time we planned and she already had the link. Bridget, thanks for joining me today. Now I have to spend a mouse click hitting the record button. It's probably the one most important click of all. So I'm gonna do that. I think we're on click 4 or 5, but I'll put the number in the bottom corner of this video so you could see how many mouse clicks we're in. Here it is, mouse click to record, and we'll pretend we just recorded an amazing hour-long video podcast. Bridget, thanks for being my guest again and joining me on the show.
Thanks for having me, Steven. See you next time.
All right, now I do have to spend one more mouse click to stop the recording. It's very important that we'll make sure all the files are uploaded. You get the individual video tracks for myself and Bridget, and we're going to use those to edit it automatically using Riverside's editor into something that's ready to publish for YouTube. So I'm going to spend the mouse click, hit the stop button. And now that's all I really have to do here. The recordings will upload and it will be ready to download and use the editor later. I'm not gonna spend a mouse click ending the call or even closing this tab because it'll do all of that without me exiting this studio. Now that we're done recording, I'm gonna spend some clicks going to the recordings page of this studio so I can export the video already ready for YouTube. I'll spend a click clicking this new tab, although I could have used the keyboard shortcut Command Shift right bracket and left bracket to switch. I'll spend another click clicking on the recorded session. From here, I'll spend another clicking the edit button in the top right corner. Another click choosing full length. Now, if you had a clean recording and I don't need to change the in and out points, I don't need to spend any clicks there. And I'm not gonna title my recording because again, I would have to click in that name field. So not doing any of that, gonna go right to exporting the video file. I'll click export in the top right. I'm gonna go with 1080p. I could spend two clicks and go to 4K resolution here, but I'm just gonna go straight to export. I'll spend one more click going back to my dashboard, and when I scroll down, this is where I can download that final recording. Now Riverside already did a side-by-side video with both me and Bridget, did the full length of the recording, so your full video podcast, and everything was already set. If you wanted to make more changes in the editor, like changing the background, removing the gap between both co-hosts, then you can do that, but I'm going for the minimum viable clickability, MVC. Now that the clip is ready, I can hover over it, click the three dots, that is another mouse click, and choose download. That file that just downloaded is ready to upload to YouTube and I can use it as my video podcast without touching it at all. Now I'm gonna use Command Tab to go to my Safari window. I could click it, but I'm gonna take that Command Tab. I'm gonna choose Select Files, click that Riverside click that just downloaded. I could do a mouse click here, but I'm gonna take an Enter key on the keyboard for this one. Now the title of the video is already highlighted, so I can title this without clicking on the mouse. I'm gonna title it the Riverside Podcast Speed Run. Now typically you would do other things to your YouTube video like add tags, a description, maybe add it to a playlist, but we're going for minimum viable clickability. So I'm actually gonna go right to the visibility tab here on the YouTube video. I'll spend a click going here, click public, And then I'm one click away from publishing this to YouTube. So can it be done? I think you can go from recording to actually publishing your video podcast on YouTube in less than 20 clicks. We did use an automation and we actually sent the link to our guest ahead of time and they knew what time to join the studio. But overall, less than 20 clicks to go from zero to a published video podcast on YouTube. Leave a comment below if you have any questions on the process or other challenges that you might like to see here on the Riverside channel. Subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon so you don't miss those future videos. We have lots of tips on video podcasting and building your setup, advanced post-production workflows, and even how to fix bad audio. Thanks for tuning in. We'll catch you in the next video.